This video series contains scientific and medical concepts aimed at informing healthcare professionals. Please note that the videos may contain visually stimulating images and movement.
Despite ME/CFS often being underdiagnosed in the absence of discrete diagnostic biomarkers, serial two-day cardiopulmonary exercise testing, or CPET testing, has proven to be a reliable, reproducible, and accurate measure of post-exertional malaise among those suffering from ME/CFS. CPET testing has been used as a validated tool for assessment of functional capacity among healthy people, as well as among individuals with a multitude of debilitating and fatiguing illnesses. It is specifically designed to assess the coordinated contributions of metabolic, cardiovascular, respiratory, and muscular inputs to overall energy generation and utilization. When repeated 2 days in a row, variability among the multiple physiologic measurements obtained during CPET testing from one day to the next remains low among both healthy individuals and among those suffering from chronic illnesses. These illnesses include heart failure, COPD, end-stage renal disease, pulmonary hypertension, and cystic fibrosis, no matter how impaired they may be.
ME/CFS patients, by contrast, appear uniquely unable to reproduce their CPET outcome measures during serial two-day testing, despite putting forth maximal effort. These individuals almost always display abnormal hemodynamic and respiratory responses during exercise upon a second day of testing that were not measured on day one of their serial CPET testing. CPET testing is particularly effective for measuring peak oxygen consumption, or VO2 peak, during exercise. VO2 peak has become a well-recognized indicator of functional capacity and as a surrogate measure of the maximum energy available for work. Individuals suffering from ME/CFS are found to be unable to reproduce their VO2 peak, reach their ventilatory threshold, achieve their peak workload, or duplicate their workload at ventilatory threshold attained on day one of CPET testing upon a second day of serial testing. CPET testing is also an effective tool for measuring the ventilatory anaerobic threshold, or VAT, as a function of assessing increases in muscle and blood pH, as well as detecting lactate and carbon dioxide concentrations. VAT is considered a reliable marker for detecting a patient's anaerobic threshold upon physiological exertion. CPET testing has demonstrated a notable reduction in ventilatory anaerobic threshold among individuals with ME/CFS, likely signaling a truncated ability to maintain aerobic metabolism and a resulting early onset of compensatory and less efficient anaerobic energy generation. Even among well-conditioned athletes, activity performed beyond the anaerobic threshold is rapidly fatiguing, cannot be sustained, and can trigger symptoms of fatigue, weakness, shortness of breath, nausea, headache, and/or muscle pain. CPET testing among those with ME/CFS not only captures a markedly low baseline anaerobic threshold, but serial testing on a second day additionally highlights further reductions in a ventilatory anaerobic threshold as compared to a day one baseline.
Many with ME/CFS thus appear to be operating almost entirely within the confines of anaerobic metabolism on the second day of serial testing, and as continued clinical symptoms suggest, may remain entirely anaerobic for several additional days beyond the completion of serial CPET testing. By way of comparison, healthy individuals that exceed their anaerobic thresholds during CPET testing will begin to recover within 10 minutes, rather than over the course of multiple days. Given the now significant body of evidence-based, literature-supported, altered cellular metabolism, in addition to clear decrements in ventilatory anaerobic threshold and peak oxygen consumption in those with ME/CFS, one could presumably simplify their understanding of the varied and diverse triggers for PEM to cellular energy requirements. Skeletal, cardiac, and vascular or GI smooth muscle, as well as both gray and white matter of the central and peripheral nervous systems, may all function aberrantly in the absence of sufficient ATP to meet their immediate needs. Serial two-day CPET testing has been clinically used to establish objective measurements supporting eligibility for disability benefits. In some cases, it may be crudely used to measure disease progression or severity. Despite these utilities, providers must weigh the benefits of CPET testing against its potential harms, which could include the induction of a prolonged worsening on an individual's ME/CFS as a result of the provocation of an extended episode of PEM.
This video was made possible by the OMF-funded Medical Education Resource Center at BHC, our generous donors, and viewers like you. Please consider making a tax-deductible donation to help keep educational resources like this one publicly available.